Fish traders at the Uganda-Congo border market of Mpondwe have complained of slow business, and they have attributed this to the effects of the COVID-19 lockdown restrictions. The market, which used to be on the Uganda side, was relocated during the COVID-19 lockdown to the Democratic Republic of Congo. Several security disruptions have seen the market stay in Congo, affecting local traders. Stanley Bwambale, the chairperson of the Mpondwe market vendors and other leaders, say that the shifting of the fish offloading market from Uganda to Congo has greatly affected the economy and livelihoods of the people in Kasese district. He says that this has greatly affected revenue collection.
This market was intended or toward 850 million only. But these days, we cannot even get 10 million in a year.
During COVID-19, as how you understand very well, we went into lockdown. So Congo did not close, did not experience that lockdown, they did not consider. So our people here automatically moved to Congo, and most of the businesses changed to Congo, like fish and very many others.
According to Muhindo, the fish dealers who are now offloading from the Congo complain of overtaxation when they offload from Uganda. He, however, disclosed that negotiations are on with the central government to have the situation reversed.
These traders, they are from outside, they are not Uganda, most of them, those who are dealing with fish, from the Sudanese, the Kenyans, the Tanzanians. So it's their right, because after lockdown, so they say that for us we shall go flooding from Jersey. So it's their right, they just move. So we are finding out the way to see how we are bringing them on board.
Kasese residents of Mpondwe are appealing to the authorities to work harder to return the fish market to the Ugandan side of the frontier.
We don't have any fish. We have only eggplants, tomatoes, and onions, the commodity which is here in our market. Yet the president lost a lot of money to build that market for us.
Other market vendors at Mpondwe have also expressed their dissatisfaction about the relocation of the fish offloading market. Traders believe that the situation can only return to normal if Uganda and DR Congo leadership discuss how the two markets can operate for the benefit of all traders on both sides. However, there's concern that if this is not done, indirect beneficiaries of the fish business will gradually be pushed out of the work. Report by Roger Sandy for the news.